Hello, this is another episode of penphysics, and today instead of solving an IB past paper, I will do theory. So I had in mind of doing simple harmonic motion using a sailor fountain pen, and in that I have put some sailor black ink. So let me use my pen and show you how to do simple harmonic motion with calculus. So I will jam in the system of mass and spring, put the mass m with a spring constant k, and let this oscillate between two extreme positions, a minus a. Okay, so this oscillates back and forth between these positions. Take everything to the right to be positive, because we know displacement is a vector, velocities are vector, and we need to know the direction, which one is positive, which one is negative. So the IB says that the solution of this, of x, where x is the position, is a sine or a cosine, depending on initial conditions. Or x is equal to a cosine of omega t, where omega is called the angular speed or the angular frequency, and this is 2 pi over the period, the time for one complete oscillation. So these are called harmonic functions because they look like nice, smooth functions. Okay. So this is the time, this is x. And whether you get a sine or a cosine really depends on the initial conditions. If you start from zero, then you will get a sine going to the right. If you start from the maximum displacement, you will get a cosine, and so forth. Okay, let's look at the force. At any time t, at any position x, you know that there is a restoring force, minus kx. This comes from Hooke's law. But this is also equal to mass times acceleration because of Newton's second law. So the acceleration is minus kappa over m. This is a constant. This describes the characteristics of the system, times x. Acceleration is meters per second squared. X is meters. So this has to have units 1 over second squared, which reminds us of omega. So we call this omega squared. So A is equal to minus omega squared x. Again, a nice squeak from the gold nib. X is a function of time. The velocity is the rate of change of x. So this is the first derivative of x with respect to time. The acceleration is the rate of change of the velocity, dv dt. So this is the second derivative with respect to time of x. So this equation really becomes the second derivative of x with respect to time is equal to minus a constant times x. And this is now a differential equation. And differential equations have solutions depending, of course, on their initial conditions for x. And in this case, the first derivative of x, the velocity. But if you try sine, for example. What is the first derivative of that? You will get an omega, a, and sine becomes a cosine. And then the second derivative of x, I get another omega from this, get the a, and the cosine becomes a minus sine. And you can see where this is going. This is x. And I have verified that this is indeed a solution to this differential equation. You could do the same thing with a cosine. So in general, the solution is x is equal to a sine of omega t plus phi zero, where phi zero is called initial phase. So if phi zero is zero, this means I'm back in this case where the body is at equilibrium position, moves to the right with the maximum velocity. So I'll get a sine function. If phi zero is 90 degrees, then you know that the sine of omega t plus 90 degrees is equal to the cosine. 90 degrees is actually a quarter of a cycle. So this corresponds to a quarter of the period, and you get a cosine, etc., etc. So this will give you not only these two cases, but any case depending on the initial condition for x and v, which is dx dt, then you know what the complete solution is, because you know what phi zero is. Thank you for watching.